Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi. Hope you all are doing well. Now today I'll be telling you that how you can convert a .pybar to .exe file. Now before converting that, let me tell you that what's the use of converting a .pybar to .exe file, why we just actually do that thing. So let's say you had made out a program, you just want to send that program to some person, to some of your friends or any other person, right? Now that person is not having Python installed into its devices. So how will that person be able to run that program and see the output, right? So exe file enables you to put out this feature that if that person which you are sending your program, if that person does not has Python installed into its devices, so what it actually do, as soon as you run out the exe file, so that will show you the output, whatever is the required output of that particular program. Right, so this is the whole idea regarding the making of the exe file. Right, so let me just open a command prompt here. Okay, so command prompt. Now today I'll be telling you two ways for doing this particular thing. Okay, two ways. First one is using one library, that is Py installer. Okay, and second one is basically a GUI interface, and that is actually auto py2exe. Right, these are the two ways that I'll be telling you today. Fine, so I just open out my command prompt and I would just try to minimize this out here for a while. What I would just do, I would just go on to this piece. See, I would just go on to that particular place where I had set out my command prompt. So that for me is Windows C, and then I have users, and then I have user here. Okay, this is the place where actually I have set out my particularly command prompt. Now, the file which I want to convert out into the exe file that I have put out onto this particular path, which is here onto my command prompt. Okay, I put out that particular file which I want to convert out. Okay, let me zoom in so that you are able to see out the command. First of all, what we can just try out is that we can just try out running out our file which we actually want to convert into exe. I could just write here, let's say my file name is animation. Okay, so with only animation would not actually work. What you just need to do is that you need to write on Python and then you can write animation.py. okay, so whatever is your file name, just write out that file name. Okay, so this is my file, which is the final output of this. Now I'll be converting this one to an exe file, right? I have written out the Python animation.py. fine. Now if I just want to check out my version of Python, so I could just simply write Python, put out double dash, and I could simply write here version, right? This will actually help me to show that okay, I'm having this much version of Python. Now one very important command that you need to have pip installed into your devices, whatever you are using. So at the time whenever you have downloaded Python, so at that case pip should be installed, and the pip should be upgraded to a newer version. Okay, so just do that thing before installing out the particular library that we need out here. Fine. Now what I would just do is that I would be installing out my library that I would be needing for converting .py to .exe. So I would just write out here pip install. Okay, I would just write install. Fine. Now as I mentioned that, what is my library name? My library name was py installer, right? So I would just write py installer, right? Now I'd be telling you before only that for me this particular library is already installed, so for me it will show that requirement already satisfied. But for you, if it is not installed till now, so for you basically it will show installing, and then after some time, after doing all of the requirements, it will actually show that it is successfully installed, right? So for me, just have a look that it is showing that requirement already satisfied, right? So this is how it actually looks out. Okay, so basically after the installation of that py installer library which we have installed, now what we'll be doing is that, let me just come down here for a while. Now I'd be converting that particular my file which I just want to convert into the exe file. Now this is the thing that I'll be doing. So what is the command that I'll be first of all following out here? So I'll be writing here py installer, my library name. Okay, py installer. After that I would put double dash, you can just call them as minus sign as well. Okay, double minus sign, and I would just write here 1 5. Okay, after that again I'll be putting these two minus sign, and here I'll be writing no console. Okay, no console. Now make sure this is the library which you are using. This is the one we are converting 1 file, and you are using no console for this particularly. Okay, and after this I'll be writing out the name of the file which I want to convert, so that is animation.py, and I would just hit out enter here. Now basically see, it is basically converting me this particular file, this is which animation.py, into the .exe file. Now see, here it is doing many things, and here basically it has converted that to me. Now, what I would just do here is that I'd be minimizing this as well. I'm just going on to this PC. I'm just opening that particular place where my file was there. So it was in users and then user find. Now, wherever you are having your file, see, for me, basically, it must not be, I don't know that is you are able to see that thing or not, but let me just make the tiles here. Fine. This is the animation one which I am able to see out here. Okay, this animation was my file. Okay, this py file which I wanted to convert. Now, wherever your file was actually existing, there you'll be getting an folder, an automatic folder will be made, that is dist, D-I-S-T-C. For me, it is. I'll just double click on this particular folder. Now, inside this folder, have a look that one of my files will be present. And now, this file would be my exe file of the converted py file. Let me right click on this and let me just open out the properties for this one. Click on the properties. And now, basically here, I don't know if you are using the laptop, so if you are able to see or not, but here, when it is written type of file, so in that case, it is written .exe. .exe is my type of file, which I am actually having out here, and I will just close this out. And if I just double click on this, so basically what it will do, it will actually run out this particular program for me, whatever I was just having, right? See out here. Fine. So this is the very first way how you can just convert out the particular py file to the exe file. This was super easy, right? I told you that it is not too much difficult to convert a .py file to a .exe file. I would just minimize this out here. Now the second way which we'll be using out, let me just again go on to the command prompt. Okay, now just let me come down and give out a new space for me for writing out here. Fine. I'd be now using out the my second library which I mentioned, and that would be actually auto py to exe. Okay, so very first thing that I'll be doing is that I'll be installing that particular. I can just zoom in a little bit more so that you're able to see clearly. Fine. So pip install, and I'll be just writing auto dash py dash to dash exe. Okay, this is, just make sure to write out the commands very clearly, because they can actually cause some errors to you as well if it is not writing the proper commands. So this auto py to exe is this another library from which you can convert a py file to exe file, and this is actually GUI based process. I would show you how. I would hit enter, and basically for me it is already actually installed. So for me it is showing that requirement already satisfied, but if you haven't done that till now, so it will basically install that particular library for you. Okay, this is all done. Now, next what I'll be doing here is that I'd be simply writing auto py to exe. I'd be simply writing out the name for my file which I'm having, and I would just hit out enter here. Now, basically, it will take some time, and just see, just have a look that you are able to see one file here, one GUI type of basically a file here, right? Now, here what you need to do is that from here, you need to click on the browse option. Okay, click on the browse option and go to that particular file, go to that particular place where you just want to convert out your py file to the exe file. Okay, now, okay, let's say for me, I just want to convert out this. Okay, let me just see that bit one. I just want to convert it out here. Fine, let's say I just want to convert it the password secure. Okay, and I would just click on this open. Fine. Now just here my path has come, which I want to whichever the file I just want to do it in .exe. So for that, the whole path for that particular file has come here. Either you can just copy and paste any path as well here if you just do not want to click on the browse. Okay. See, now just have a look even that downside here, you'll be able to see out whole of the commands which are actually trying here. Basically, if you just want to use out this auto py to exe, you can just use out this command as well, which is actually coming out here, right? And now it is all done, and now simply I just need to click on convert.py to .exe, and see, it is basically showing me that converting, and basically it is basically here showing out me converting. Now it will actually take some time, and it will convert this particular file for me. Now it will totally depend that how much large this file is. Actually, the file which I have taken, that is a little bit of large, right? So it will take a little bit of time for converting .py to .exe, right? Okay, so basically it has converted this file for me, and now see here it is showing me that complete. At last, it is showing me complete, right? Now what I could just do is that I can click on this particular option which is open output folder. I can click on this. Okay, let me just minimize this out as well. So see, this is my folder where it has actually converted this particular file for me. Okay, I would just double click on this one. That was my password secure. Okay, let me just again zoom in here so that I am able to show you everything very clearly. Fine. Now just have a look. Password secure was the name for my file, which was actually which I just wanted to convert from .py to .exe, right? So here is that password secure file, and now I could just go and click on the properties as well, and now just have a look on the properties that it is showing me that the file is .exe, right? So basically, I hope that you are very much clear that how you can actually convert a .py to .exe file, right? Basically, you have two options. Any of the libraries you can just use according to your choice, whatever you just wish out, right? So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and take care.